Hello everyone, myself Roshan Kumar. I secured All India Rank 114 in Civil Services Examination 2018. First topic for GS Paper 1 is Indian Art and Culture. You must have covered the basics of this topic during your prelims preparation. You have to just add on that preparation. Three reference books are for this topic. First one is NCERT book, An Introduction to Indian Art. And second is Nitin Singhania book on Art and Culture. And third is NIOS book on Art and Culture. These three books you can refer because you have already done the homework during your prelims preparation. And doing that for mains will not be a very tough thing. So you can refer this Nitin Singhania book selectively for major topics like Buddhism, Jainism, Bhakti movement, architecture and all these things. That covers it comprehensively. And this NIOS book, that is given topic wise, and they have given in very crisp manner all the details for that topic. So doing that will be comprehensive for this paper. So these three different sources, Indian Art and Culture from NCERT, Nitin Singhania book and NIOS is full and final resource for this topic. Second topic for GS paper 1 is Modern Indian History. There are three different sources for this topic. First is NCERT history book from class 6 to 8 and second is NCERT history book for class 12. There are three different themes for class 12 history book. You refer all these three books and NCERT 6 to 8. Other than that, political science book for class 12, which is about India's post-independence history, this is sufficient for this topic. And along with this, you must take note of the current affair debate, which may be on different topics like when these files on Subhash Chandra Bose were declassified by Government of India, there was debate on that, or other than that, also like Mahatma Gandhi's role in South Africa and his role in world history, world politics, all these things were in debate recently. So you also must take note of these things to comprehensively address the questions which may arise from this section. Third topic is about freedom struggle and its various stages. For this, you must have already covered the NCERT and Spectrum book. That already builds a solid base for this topic. But for analysis section, you must refer this Bipin Chandra book on India's struggle for independence, because that gives an analytical perspective on various stages during the India's independence struggle, and that will comprehensively address the demand of mains questions. So you don't make no comprehensive notes from that book, but at least after completing the NCERT and Spectrum book, you can just go through that book once or twice to give you a definitive perspective on various stages, various eminent personalities, various important events during the freedom struggle, and that is the comprehensive source for this topic. Topic 4 for GS paper 1 is Post-Independence India. For this topic, there are two sources. One is Bipin Chandra's book India Since Independence. From that book, covering from chapter 6 to 12, will address the demand of this topic comprehensively. Another source is class 12 political science book of NCERT. These two sources, any of these two, will address the demand of questions arising from this topic. Fifth topic for GS paper 1 is about world history. For this topic, you can refer either of these two sources. First is Arjun Dev book on world history, and another is old class 10 NCERT on world history. Either of these two sources can fulfill the demand of questions which will come in mains. And you also must take note of the current affairs about various world history topics like role of Mahatma Gandhi in South Africa and other things which are in debate nowadays. So this is more than sufficient for this topic. Sixth topic for GS paper 1 is about salient features of Indian society. For this, sociology book of NCERT class 11 about Indian society is a sufficient source. And then correlating the events in Indian society or changes in Indian society which you must get through the newspaper reading will be more than sufficient for addressing the demand of questions which will arise from this section. Seventh topic for GS paper 1 is about role of women, population associated issues, poverty, urbanization and various other issues which are arising in Indian society at as well as at global level. For this topic, the newspaper is going to be the best source. From newspaper reading, you can get multiple perspective on these issues and integrate this perspective at regional, global as well as national level also, and this will comprehensively address the demand of this topic. Eighth topic is about effects of globalization. All these topics, means like topic 7th, which was about role of women and population associated issues, both these topics are in continuation. So for both these topics, you must refer the newspapers thoroughly. And one thing I would like to point out specifically is that whenever you are in doubt about any of these topics, then just try to Google the meaning of those terms, and once you are able to comprehend these terms in a easy language and you are able to write it down, then by taking reference of current affairs, the news which are appearing in day-to-day affairs, by that you will get a unique advantage while writing the mains answer. And by refining those sources thoroughly, you can address the demand of questions arising from this section. Ninth topic is about social empowerment, communalism, regionalism and secularism. All these topics are in debate in day-to-day affairs at regional, national as well as international level. So for these topics also, you must understand the meaning of these terms in very simple language, and you must be able to write it down during the mains examination. And once you are able to write down or comprehend the meaning of these terms in easy language, then you can just give the contemporary context for these questions arising from this section, and that will be sufficient for addressing the demand of question. Tenth topic is about physical geography and geophysical phenomena. For this topic, NCERT class 11 book on physical geography is sufficient. That explains the various concepts and of physical geography in a very simple language. By reading those concepts, you can contemporize those concepts from day-to-day affairs, like various events of cyclone, earthquake and tsunami. By understanding those things, you are able to keep that in memory for a longer time, and you can write that examples in mains answer. That will give you a unique advantage also. So this is sufficient for this topic. 12th topic is about distribution of key natural resources. For this topic, there are two books from class 12th NCERT geography book. One is Human Geography and another is India, People and Economy. Both these two books will cover your basics correctly, and then giving contemporary examples about these topics will address the demands of questions from this topic comprehensively. As a concluding remark to the topics of GS paper 1, I would like to add some pointers. These are, first, this is one of the most lengthy GS papers, so keep your resources to minimum, and this will be helpful also because you have already completed various topics of this paper during your prelims preparation, and various add-on topics can be done after prelims also. So answer writing is also going to be very important because this is a lengthy paper and questions will be demanding. So ensure that you have done enough answer writing practice so that you can complete the paper in mains examination on time. And practicing diagram is also important because practicing diagram prior to your real exam will help you to reproduce those diagrams in your real examination. And giving contemporary context to the static content also is very important because that will make your answer interesting to read and will give you unique advantage in mains. So ensure that you are able to give contemporary examples even for static portions.
Don't forget to subscribe with us and press the bell icon to never miss the video on Chanakya IAS Academy.